Horn was sent to us on the 4th, 3rd? 3rd. Would you like to sign it?
This is a requisition form that has been presented to the finance department for the manager's signature by the budget committee chairman. And attached to that is a document, which is a letter from the law firm of Cleveland Waters and Bass, which the budget committee chairman appears to have signed on the 29th of December. It calls for there to be a retention of outside counsel by the budget committee, and for there to be a payment of a retainer of $2,000, which is the entirety of the budget committee's line for counsel, and for there to be a monthly billing against that amount with a replenishment of the retainer to keep it at the $2,000 level. I have advised the board that the budget committee does not have authority to hire counsel on its own, that authority lies with this board, and that any action to retain outside counsel needs to come before this board as a request.
Okay. Question.
I also note that there has been an invoice, a redated invoice that has been presented to the finance department by the chairman. Apparently, the invoice was redated to December 29, 2016.
How do we know it was redated?
This comes at the bottom of an email chain where the an attorney at the Office of Cleveland Waters and Bass, addressed to Mary Louise Woolsey, says, attached is the redated invoice that you requested. Please let us know if you need anything further.
I'd like to make a motion to direct the town manager not to sign the request, pending a authorized request from the budget committee to the board to implement it there at our next meeting. To come to that next meeting with a request for what they want to do. That's my motion.
I'll second it. Any other questions?
Discussion?
Yeah. I'm referring to the genesis of this request. I had several questions from reading the budget committee. Minutes starting in 1632, the date is 12-20-16. It's Mary Louise Woolsey, the chair. Budget committee members received a letter last week, most on Friday, from the town council requesting information from the budget committee under the right to know law. And the budget committee response is as follows. Stated for Barbara that 8 members of the budget committee signed the request. So the comments from the chair on this are specific. They're limited specifically to 91A. There are no other issues that the chair is addressing. Mr. Pierce makes a motion, as the minutes reflect. If you please, along this line, that line would be the 91A request. But ask that the budget committee instruct the chairman to retain an appropriate lawyer to assist the budget committee in legal matters concerning its legal duties and obligations, specifically, as he stated, along this line. Town council has provided a training session to not only the budget committee, but to all boards for 91A. It's a very important part of public service. The selectmen receive 91As, town executive staff does, and it's complied with within state law. It's a fundamental obligation that anybody that works for the town or anybody that holds elected office and anybody that is appointed is the chairperson of the budget committee is sworn to uphold. So along these lines, there's a request to hire outside counsel. Again, town esquire, Mr. Girard, this brings to all the boards. It's been patterned by the chair, Ms. Wilson, while she was a select person, to routinely engage in continuing meetings, continuing discussions, and emailing selectmen. That's a year and a half, 2 years ago, prior to her not getting reelected and prior to her being appointed as the chair by the budget committee. Additionally, their meetings and their email traffic were deemed in use of the second legal opinion by the New Hampshire Municipal Association. We pay the New Hampshire Municipal Association $17,000 a year. One of the big things we get from them is legal advice. And Mr. Buckley is informed, town attorney, in a review of the emails that there were violations of the rights in that one. So this is a specific issue. It is a fundamental concept that all elected and appointed officials must comply with. You never see the Board of Selectmen fighting 91A requests. You never see town executive or command element folks, including the town manager, refusing information requests, and it's inappropriate. As such, the Budget Committee wants to spend $2,000 of hard-earned taxpayer money, $2,000 of somebody's money in this town, to get a third opinion, a third legal opinion. And there's no shortage of lawyers, in our country that will be glad to find an opinion that they can make $2,000 on and go argue. And I will staunchly defend taxpayer rights if the Budget Committee refuses to. But it's a Board of Selectmen. Anyone that wants to waste taxpayer money on something as frivolous as this, I will oppose. And Jim, I understand your motion, but this is a specific 91A, and it does not allude to any other legal issues. Mr. Giraud is happy in a beneficent, harmless way to give legal advice to the Budget Committee. And we also, through proper communication channels for the Budget Committee, have access to the New Hampshire Municipal Association. And they've already deemed this illegal meetings. And I'm not interested in voting against your motion and oppose it, because it doesn't do anything to shed light and say no to the specific 91A request. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I agree with what Phil said, and I
have
anything further to add.
Well, I agree with what Phil said. The 91A should just be, if there's nothing to hide, 91A is very simple to comply with and to follow through with. But I think they should have the right, as a committee, to come before us and make the request. And we can discuss it at that point and make the make our decision and our vote at that point in our meeting. I think it's foolishness. I think if there's nothing to hide, there's no reason not to produce your emails. There's been two legal opinions. The emails have been looked at by town council and by the New Hampshire Municipal Association, and both people have said this is an illegal meeting, that somebody has replied to the email and is the opportunity to reply, and that makes it a meeting. But I still think that following proper procedure, they should be able to come before us and request it. That's why I made the motion. That's how I feel that way.
Okay.
Well, even if we don't approve that motion, they still
have a right to come to us at any point in time.
Yeah.
They have a right to come to us and ask for to question us on policy, or
no. But if they want to
ask for policy or ask for the not permission, but the put in the request for doing that, mm-hmm. and we can forward that on.
Mm-hmm.
So, but that's the chain. That's the way it's supposed to go.
Okay.
It's got to come to us and then go to the town manager, because he's the only one in town that can sign contracts, if I'm not mistaken. You're the only one that has the authority to sign contracts.
With the exception of the library.
And your motion is saying not to sign it, but they can come to us.
Okay, Kevin says that don't sign it, they can come to us.
Okay. All those in favor? All those opposed? 2-2, motion fails.
I would make a motion that the Board of Selectmen refuses to approve or authorize any legal expenditure from any board, any body in this town, appointed, elected, or employee, that refuses to provide within state of New Hampshire law responses to 91 alpha requests.
second that. Any questions? All those in favor? Three? Opposed? One.
I would like to make a 91A request, make this motion. The contract that was initially signed by the elected or the appointed chair of the budget committee, the attorney's letter back to the chair was a redraft. Is that correct, Mr. Trump?
Redated. The invoice.
I would like to request to make a 91A on behalf of the board, and then this is a motion. The board requests that we see the initial date and contract and the email for discussions. There is no lawyer client privilege. And exactly what the date were and why that was redated.
I have a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Any questions? All those in favor? Unanimous.
No, sir.
Do we need to a motion to seal or unseal the minutes from the prior meeting?
I would make a motion that we unseal or not seal the minutes of the non-public.
Second.
I'll second that. Okay.
Unanimous. Okay.
Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, I was asked to come before the board based on some concerns that brought to our attention from the previous budget committee meeting with regard to the costing on the Firefighters 3017 contract. We'll pass out to the board here. These are the costing items that finance has produced for us. Basically, an overview is we've gone back and very closely looked at the costing items to ensure that it meets the direction that we initially had from the board. In doing so, we did find some errors that changed that number that is in the current warrant articles, only the number. And so I would recommend, I have to go through each of these, that the board authorize an amendment to those, to the new figures we have in these costing sheets. And I'd also share with the board that we are putting up on, you know, all of the TAs now have been ratified and they've all been signed. So we'll be putting them up on the website as we speak. I teased it over that. And if you approve these, we'll also put the costing figures with them and share them tonight with the budget committee as well. So starting with 3017s, before you, there's two sheets on each one of these. The first sheet on the top is the current amended. It's dated 1-5. The second one is the 12-8 version. And essentially what happened in 3017 is you see there's a significant difference. If you look on the right column, I'm sorry.
This is the back
one. It's your last one.
So at the top of it, it'll say cost analysis for fire supervisory local 3017, and the first page is dated 1-5-17. We'll start with that one.
Mm-hmm.
And so the costing numbers, and Christy will jump in and correct me if I say something incorrectly, but if you look to the right column down, there's a bolded in issue that says $337.58. That is the total costing, the compounded accumulated cost of the contract over the 3 years, that final big number that's in the warrant article. That number is down from 443,157, the second page you see in the same bolded area, 443,157. We went back and we found an error in a portion of the compounding figure that essentially double counted a compounding issue, and it made it inflate substantially. So it basically took what was a compounded number and compounded it again, which obviously is the math error. So we've corrected that to read appropriately 330758. And also further down on the bottom for these, we've included what the cost savings will be. As we talked about when we went through this with you folks, and the TA's call for concessions on 3017 and 2664, an additional contribution towards medical, as well as an adjustment in 2018 to a new medical prescription plan, which will result in savings to the town for the public benefit. We've added what those savings numbers are as well. So I'd ask the board first to answer any questions. The other ones are on here as well. We went back and checked them to make sure the math was correct and there were no errors. There are some changes in each of those as well. Similarly, we'll go to the 2664. We recommend adjusting that number from 762451 to 782079. No, other way around, pardon me. From from the 782075 to the 762451. Then with regard to the Teamsters, to go from 351,428 to 323,732. And then from the SEA, to go from 576,946 to 534,042.
Any questions from the board?
The motion would read?
We would ask the board to direct us to amend the warrant articles to the numbers we just described. First, I take a motion on that, and then ask the board to, with those new numbers, again ratify that you support those numbers.
I make a motion to amend the numbers as corrected. Second.
All those in favor?
And a second motion that you again recommend to the public to support those on the warrant, the new amended numbers.
I'll make a motion.
I'll second it.
All those in favor? Unanimous.
Very good. That's all I have, unless you have any questions I can answer for you.
That's
all I have.
Okay. Do we have any? Do we want to talk about that?
Or just... Sure. Before you, was in your packets today was a copy of the IT review report we had outside vendor come in to deal with. That's there for your review. We're also tonight going to share that with the budget committee. They've been requesting that. We'll put it in their packets for tonight as well.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. I make a recommendation to make a motion to adjourn at 4:58 p.m. the public session.
Second. All those in favor? Unanimous.
Hey, Jamie.
Hi.
Can I get a copy of that IT report now?
Yeah.
Don't worry.